lovely to see you. I would have been here so much sooner if it hadn't been for Carl. He's certainly a grandpa the way he drives.
You did get here in one piece, Liz.
Wow, you have certainly done the place up a bit. Oh, Susie, it's so nice to see
yes.
you.
Oh, yes, you too. Oh. How was your flight?
Oh, dreadful. You know what you went through in that container? I have just lived it. It's a really poor excuse for an airline. It's so nice to see you. I haven't seen you for so long.
No. Or B.
Oh, B. Oh, sweetie. Oh, that Finn. What you went through, it's dreadful. And then when Susie told me that you didn't actually make it to live with your dad, it's heartbreaking. I mean, the fact that you've been sleeping on other people's couches with nowhere to call home is terrible. You know, you always were a little headstrong thing, though, weren't you? Didn't I say, Susie, when she was little, when she was a baby, I said she's so independent she wants to do things for herself.
I didn't just sleep on people's couches. You've got no idea.
Oh, I think there's something wrong.
So the whole time that B was homeless, you never picked up on that?
Oh, we only spoke occasionally on the phone, and she led me to believe that she was living with her dad in Broome.
Well, I can't believe that Lars never told you that she didn't turn up.
He'd already cut off contact by then. And look, maybe B was lying to him as well.
Mum, I need to know what happened. Before B left, she said that I told you that I wanted you to kick her out.
Do we have to go into all that?
Yes. That's why you're here.
It's Carl. He's found B.
Like that. I honestly don't remember telling you anything that would suggest that.
B was 15. She was a terror. There's all those teenage hormones.
Answer the question. Did I ever say or do anything that implied I didn't want B around?
I think that B has got her memories mixed up.
So this had nothing to do with me?
Of course not. I wanted her to go and spend time with her dad. Now, I'm not saying she's lying, but maybe she felt that the world was against her and she's just made it into something it wasn't.
You're not going to wait till B comes back?
No. I'll let her have a night's sleep and then we can talk in the morning. Oh, look, make sure that I talk to B first. Once I've spoken to her, we can just put this whole thing behind us.
Night. Maybe waiting till tomorrow when everyone's got a clear head would be best.
She has spent the last 5 years thinking I'm the one who wanted her out on the street, holding on to all that anger. I don't know how she's going to accept. It was all for nothing.